Today we're building the KiwiCo Labs Planetarium Projector. It has a bunch of cool constellations on it so that you can have space right in your bedroom and light up your walls with a night sky. Let's get building. All right, now we can start building. First, we're gonna grab our blue base and the light. And we're gonna add the green switch first. We wanna make sure that the dash is on the left, the circle is on the right. So this threads in right here, and then you just push it back to pop it in place. Bam. Okay, our first stop and check. Make sure the circle is next to the off and the dash is next to the on. And make sure we have it set as off before we go forward. Now we're gonna press the light into this circle in the center, line it up, and then just press down. It sort of clicks in place. Make sure to push the wires down in between this notch, right here, and then the cable through this notch. Now we can set the blue gear on top. Now we have our sun gear. It fits into this shape. You might need to give it a little wiggle, make sure it sits nice and flat. Now this little gear has the Earth and a tiny moon on it, and it fits right in between the sun and the ring gear. Make sure the gears are nice and meshed together so it spins. So this little bottle shows how our solar system works. If you spin it, you can see the moon rotates around the Earth and the Earth rotates around the sun. So take the wooden base and make sure that the logo is facing down. We're gonna take one of our dark blue frame pieces and put it into this little triangular shape. Now use a small green bolt to attach the frame to the wooden piece. Now repeat steps 7 to 8 four times. Now we're gonna attach four more frame pieces with four more green bolts. Now we can flip it over. Now add the top frame piece on what we just built. It's going to connect to all of these pieces, but it's easiest if we just do it one at a time. These prongs will slide into this rectangle and snap in place. So just line it up and press. Snap. Now that we have one, we can go all the way around and do the rest of them. Let's stop and make sure that there are no gaps between the frame pieces. It looks like all five of my frame pieces are snapped in all the way and there's no gaps. Looks good. We have three different types of star panels that come with it. One with stars, one with constellations, and one that's blank. We're gonna save the blank ones for later. Now, take one of your star panels and fold these tabs away from the picture. Like that. And these tabs are gonna fit right into these slots on the frame. You can place them wherever you want. Now, just repeat steps 13 and 14 to fit in all the triangles. If a tab pops out, that's fine. Just push it back in once you're done adding the panels. And now the frame with the star panels lines up. These green bolts line up with these holes in the base, and boop, there it is. All right, you're almost done. Ask a grown-up to help you find a USB power source and plug it in. You did it! Now turn off the lights and let your star shine. All right, it's all built. Everything looks great, but I have a couple tips for you in case you hit some snags along the way. If your gears aren't spinning smoothly around, make sure that all three gears, your sun gear, your planet gear, and your ring gear, are nice and flat and the teeth are meshed together. That way it spins nice and smooth. If your light isn't turning on, make sure the cable is securely plugged in and the switch is switched on. If one of your star panels got a little crumpled or bent, you can just smooth it out over the side of the table and then it's nice and flat again. If your star panels aren't fitting together quite right, check out your frame, see if there's any gaps, and then click it back together. All right, now that we have all our tips, it's time to turn on our projector. I suggest putting it close to a wall or in a corner. That way those stars that are projected on the wall will be sharper so you can tell what constellations you're looking at. You can also change the placement of the constellations in your room by spinning it with this wooden base. You can spin it either way. And if you want to see what's going on inside the projector, you can remove a few of the panels on one side so you can see your sun, your earth, and your moon. And don't forget to turn it off if you're leaving for a while. It's not good to leave electronics unattended. So when I was prototyping this and playing with some kids, they really liked that it came with all of the cool constellations, but they also wanted to make their own. And that has become my favorite part of this crate. So it comes with these blank panels, and then I can use the silver pen and I can draw whatever constellation I want. I'm gonna do an A for Alex. And then I'm gonna mark where my stars would be on the A. And then my favorite part, I'm gonna use the pen to punch the holes into the blank piece, but I need to do that on top of the crate that it comes in. Punch. There we go. Now I have my very own A, so I can project my name into the stars. The Earth might seem like a big place, but it's actually really tiny compared to a star. Over 1 million Earths can fit into a star like our sun, which is pretty funny because when you look at the night sky, all the stars look so small, but that's just because they're really, really far away. Something else cool about our solar system is that our sun is 93 million miles away. And it takes 8 minutes for the light from the sun to reach us all the way here on Earth. The next closest star is almost 25 trillion miles away. That is so far. Astronomers actually use light years to talk about distance. So 1 light year means it takes light 1 year to reach us. The star that's 25 trillion miles away is a little over 4 light years away. That means it takes the light more than 4 years to reach us. Thanks so much for building along with me today. To see more cool builds like this one, make sure to subscribe to our channel. See you next time, bye. It has all of your favorite constellations featured. I don't know if these are your favorite. I don't know. Yeah, okay. It's just spaces up there.
It feels sad.
Fit into a sun like our star.
That's so cool. Toots and toots out there in cyberspace.